पीपल आर अवेयर अबाउट द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैज़ इनिशिएटेड फॉर द रिफॉर्म इन द लेबर लॉस. अर्लियर इट वॉज डिसाइडेड टू हैव द फोर कोर्ट्स आउट ऑफ द 44 acts. देन इट वॉज फर्दर डिसाइडेड टू हैव द फोर कोर्ट्स आउट ऑफ 29 acts. एंड दिस फोर कोर्ट्स नाउ इट हैज़ बीन पास्ड इन द पार्लियामेंट. इट हैज़ पास्ड टू द स्टैंडिंग कमिटी ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट टू. एंड देन द नेमली एज ए मिनिमम वेज कोड, IR दैट इज इंडस्ट्रियल रिलेशंस कोड, OSH ऑक्यूपेशनल सेफ्टी एंड हेल्थ एंड वर्किंग कंडीशंस कोड, एंड द फोर्थ वन इज सोशल सिक्योरिटी कोड. इज ऑल फोर कोड्स आर passed by the parliament, and prior to that it was consulted with the all 11 central trade unions of India on a different forum, on a different manner even. After that, now the stage has come of the draft rules. After the code, there has to be preparations for the rules, and rules has been now drafted. So under the stage it is drafting the rules. Now again, the government is inviting any objections out of these draft rules from any of the central trade union. Even it is open to the public also in the portal of the Government of India's Labour and Employment Ministry. Whatever the objections or whatever the comments, you can submit it also. After that, these rules will take place and will be admissible to throughout the country. Out of these, as a BMS, Bharatiya Mazdoor Sangh, we welcome the two major codes. One is minimum wage code, which is giving a benefit to the our all unorganized employees. Basically, you are all aware that out of 100% workforce of the country, 6 to 7% are working in the unionized sector or the main public sector, private sectors or medium scale industries. But rest of the 94% of the workforce is working in the unorganized sectors. Sometimes you say it is a casual worker, contractual worker, theka worker, whatsoever. And these worker groups were not being provided with a minimum wage. So it is a compulsion, and it is required, is a necessity of the day also, that the minimum wage should be provided to us. So that's why this code is welcomed by the BMS. Second one is about social security code. This social security code is also providing the social security for all, which BMS has demanded in their 2011 the Jalgaon Triannual Conference, All India Conference, that social security for all. On the basis of that also, it has been designed, it has been consulted, it has been discussed with the different forums, different employers group, different employees groups also. And it is also the one of the best one is that this social security, like provident fund, gratuity, pensions and everything, is being provided to these groups also. As we know right now, the organized groups, that is in a unionized categories, these people are getting the benefit of PF, pensions, gratuity, etc., etc. And that's why it is being welcomed by the BMS for there. There are these two codes, rest of the two codes, that is one is IR code and it is OSH and WC code, which has been some problem, that is basically, that is some of the provisions are, we feel it is anti-labor provisions or it is not helping to the workforce. So that's why we have put our comments to the Government of India. We are trying to negotiate this also prior to formulation of the rules also. Other trade unions are also invited for that even also. You know that in this COVID-19 pandemic situation also, the Government of also India also invited to discuss and consult with the different groups also via different modes, than on the 1st May, then 6th May, and then also the other way, that is the provident fund committee meetings, where it is combined of the employers, employee and government groups, ESI, where it is employer, employee and government groups also, that they are been discussed and consulted even also. But these are the major provisions which are available in the IR codes, and this it is having a little bit rather than say the more, even also that some of the dangerous situations may prevail in the country, and that's why the workforce is required. I would like to draw the attention on that also, the very previous one even also. If you go back 300 years back even also, at that time, government was forced to bring the law of a maximum wage only. If you go back 300 years back, because at that time, the employee were not available. Employment was available, but employee was not available. And that's why the wage has been raised like anything, because the employee were exploiting the employer at that time. And that's why the government was forced to bring to the maximum wage. So now it is a total reverse situation. Employment is not available, and there's employees are being exploited. So that's why minimum wage is required for also. As we seen also, the different states are having the different minimum wage. And that's why in this minimum wage code, one national floor level minimum wage will be clarified. And then furthermore also, as a region-wise or the state-wise, it has been given liberty to the state governments to further modify to that even also, but on the upward direction, not on the downward direction. That is what. So these are the some good provisions, and some are the bad provisions of the IR and the OSH codes also. But in OSH code also, the women work were well allowed to work in the night shift even also. Though it was demanded by the our young engineer girls, that has been even, because as they have completed their mines engineering and other engineering, they would like to work with this also. So that is one. And secondly also, the safety aspects, who will take care? We see that the contractual employment, the contractor is not taking the care for this. So we request the government of India that at least principal employer, wherever they are contract working also, they should take care for the all safety equipments for the safety of the workers. And there are the some the very dangerous situations like chemical industries, and in recently also in the nearby Chennai also, Visakhapatnam also, few months back even also, there was a very heavy explosions, and the 8 to 10 people were died even also. This kind of incident and accidents are being continued in the country also, specifically in the more chemical industries also. So that's why it is necessary for that to how to plug in the house, so that the unsafe activities may not continue, and the safety of the workers, safety of the employers, and that's why the safety of the residents nearby area also will be taken care for that. So that way we are taking care for that even also. These are the provisions required. In IR situation also, today anyone under the Trade Union Act 1926, seven people can get the registration out of wherever they are. And then further, it was also given the delegation of power to the deputy labor commissioner of the state even also, wherever he is working. Now in these also, we would like to have the same phenomena, and otherwise it will be very difficult to get the registrations. Once the registration of trade union is not available, then the new registration trade union or trade union will not able to function well. Same way, that is a clause of recognition of the trade union. The recognition of the trade union is also not under the code of recognitions. Now different industries are giving the recognitions, but we require to have the recognitions throughout the as a national trade union, and then furthermore to the different industries level also. This both way the recognition is very important, and for that also in the rules, in the draft rules, it is not being very much specifically entered. So that's why I would like to enter into the some specific words to that even also. One that is after the some consultations, it is also that we required also everything, whatever it is in this the contractual employment, the principal employer may be the main responsible person if the contractor is failed to provide this all kind of facilities, that we would like to enter into that, which is prevailing right now even also. And then even about the IR codes research, that is a threshold limit, which was earlier it is 100. Now it has been shifted to the 300 and more the workers. So it will be applicable to that also. So the, for a closer, the permissions were required for a 100, 100 and more than from government. That has been shifted to 300 and more also. So that will make that the those working less than below the 300, the closer will be very easy for them. And so that we can say as a hire and fire immediately it's possible. And as we have seen, there also the many industries now dividing their companies, like with the electricity board. Now board has been divided into 7 different companies. So same thing, the industries are also dividing them also. If their workmen are more than 400 also, they will divide it into 200, 200 each. So that's why, again, the closure will be very easy for them also. So that's why it is also the questions that the survival for the our industry, survival for the employer and survival for the employees also it is there. Because after the terminations of the employee, so the one can easily able to go to the court and court's verdict. So in this case also the employee may not be able to go to the court even also. And that's why the, his terminations will not be granted back. Or rather we say it is a restatement through the courts even also. That will be very difficult. The say will not be hard about that. So these are the some provisions where we are forced or we are rather compelled to go against the government, and though we would like to oppose those provisions of the government, and which is to my mind is in the interest of employee as well as in the interest of employer, and same way in the interest of government too. Why the government? Because government has to govern this society, and so society is to be benefited out of the any industry. Because like a simple example, any product which is being sold out or is being coming out of the industry, it is being used by the society. So the benefit should also goes to the society. So that's why the kind of things also, because once the employer closes down the industry, then it will be a loss to the society, it will be loss to the employer, and it will be loss to the employees too. So it's not necessary, it's not to become easy to close down the employer industries. It will be in the interest of all of us. So that's why this kind of provisions to be made. And these all are rectification also. All the central trade unions has asked right from the back in the 1991 also, and they were requiring some reforms out of this even also, and they would like to find out, because some of the definitions which are required to change it also. So there is a workers definition in the different tax is different, so that is also required to change it, because to give the maximum benefit to out of them also. And so some of the good pensionable schemes and everything is also to be required to be announced by the government in the interest of the employees where they were working, and in the interest of the unorganized employees to be working out. So at this junction we are there even also, and we are waiting for the government response. It's also draft rules are in pending. Either way, this or that way, the some small consultations are in progress. But as a Bharatiya Mazdoor Sangh, we had in the second week of February, once again, it is our great proud that we are meeting in Chennai. All over our India Executive Committee is meeting over here. We would like to strategize. We would like to plan about that also during this period of at least 1 month. So right now also, so the whatever the progress is made between the government and the central trade unions will be available to us. And then at that time, we will try to plan out the different programs or acceptability, or what are the acceptability or not, at, or what can be changes can be adopted. That's all. Thank you.
சுதந்திரம் வாங்கலிருந்து ஒவ்வொரு மாற்றம் செய்கின்ற போதும் கூட சில பிரச்சனைகள் வரும். நீங்க பெருந்தலைவர் காமராஜர் பத்தி நான் சொல்ல வேண்டியதில்லை.
இல்ல இல்ல வணிகனும் நான் கேட்க முழுக்க சொல்லல. அது கூவத்தை ஒட்டி வந்து கொண்டு போனா சில ஹோட்டலை பாதிக்கும். மக்கள் வாழும் பகுதியை ஒட்டி கொண்டு போவது என்பதாகத்தான் அவர்களுடைய கோரிக்கையாக
இல்ல அது மாற்றம் செய்யணும் மாற்றம் செய்யணும் நம்ம திட்டத்தை புறக்கணிக்க கூடாது திட்டம்
மக்களுக்கு
தனிநபர் லாபத்திற்காக நாம் அதை அனுமதிக்க முடியாது
ஒப்பந்தக்காரர்கள் வந்து சென்ற ஆளுங்கட்சி வந்து அவர்கள் வந்து எல்என்டிலிருந்து சப்கான்ட்ராக்ட் வாங்கிட்டு சோமா கம்பெனி மூலமாக அதை செய்தார்கள் என்பதனால் வலியுறுத்தினார்கள்
வந்து அப்படி மக்களை பாதிக்கணும்னா பாரதிய மஸ்து சங்கம் முன்னின்று போராட்டம் நடந்தோம் நீங்க பாரதிய மஸ்து சங்கத்தின் வரலாறு நடவடிக்கைகள் முழுசா படிச்சு பாத்தீங்கன்னா எந்த அரசியல் சார்பும் நிற்காது நின்றதும் இன்னைக்கு வரைக்கும் கிடையாது ஆனால் சில சில செய்திகள் வருகின்ற போது எங்களுக்கு அது மனவேதனையாக இருக்குது ஏன் இதை குறிப்பிடுறாங்கன்னு ஏன்னா எங்கள் மேலே குற்றச்சாட்டு சொல்ல முடியாது முழுக்க முழுக்க 1955 துவக்கப்பட்டு அமைப்பு சொல்றேன். இதுவரைக்கும் வந்து பிளவுபடாத ஒரு அமைப்பா இருக்கு. அரசியல் சார்ந்த சங்கங்கள்லாம் ஒவ்வொரு கட்சி தலைவரும் வெளியே போறப்போ ஒரு சங்கம் உருவாகுது. ஏன்னா ஏஐடிசி தொழிற்சங்கமே ஆல் இந்திய ட்ரேட் யூனியன் காங்கிரஸ் சுதந்திரத்துக்கு முன்னால் அது ஆரம்பிக்கப்பட்டது. நேரு பிரதமரானார், தொழிலாளிகள் மறந்தாங்க, ஏஐடிசிங்கிறது கம்யூனிஸ்ட் தொழிற்சங்கமாக போயிடுச்சு. ஏஐடிசி யார் எடுத்துட்டா? கம்யூனிஸ்ட்காரர் கையில் எடுத்துட்டார். அப்புறம் காங்கிரஸுக்கு ஐஎன்டிசி வந்தது, அதுலேருந்து ஹெச்எம்எஸ் வந்தது. தமிழ்நாட்டில் எடுத்துட்டிங்கன்னா எல்பிஎஃப் வந்தது, எம்ஜிஆர் போனதுனால ஏடிபி வந்தது, வைகோ போனதுனால எம்எல்ஏ வந்தது. இதனால் என்ன, தொழிலாளி கூறுபட்டு பிரிக்கப்பட்டு தொழிலாளர் சக்திகள் பிரிக்கப்பட்டது. நாம் இப்போ ஜேஏசியில் எல்லா சங்கத்தையும் தான் சேர்த்து பேசிகிட்டு இருக்கோம். இப்போ டிஃபென்ஸ் போன்றவர்கள் எல்லாம் மத்திய சர்க்கார் எடுத்து நம்ம ஆர்ப்பாட்டம் பண்ணோம்னா பிஎம்எஸ் பண்ணுறதில்லை. ஒருங்கிணைந்து அந்த செயல்பாட்டை நாம் செய்கிறோம். காரணம் என்ன, தொழிலாளி சக்தி பிளவுபடக்கூடாது. ஏன்னா தொழிலாளர் சக்தி தொழிலாளர் சம்பளத்துக்காக மட்டும் இல்லைங்கிறது தான் பாரதிய மஸ்தூர் சங்கத்தின் நோக்கம். அது தேசிய வளர்ச்சிக்காக இருக்கணும், தேசத்தின் வளர்ச்சிக்காக தொழிலாளி பங்கு இருக்கணும். ஏன்னா தொழிலாளி தேசபக்த தொழிலாளனாக உருவாக்குவது தான் பாரதிய மஸ்தத்துவ சங்கத்தினுடைய தேங்கடி ஜெயந்திக்கு நூற்றாண்டு விழா கொண்டாடி இருக்கோம். அவரோட நோக்கமும் எண்ணமும் அதுதான்.